Hi, hello everyone, welcome back to our channel. In this video, we are going to solve the last challenge in flow collections and loop superbatch unit. And the name of the challenge is configure your screen flow to collect and save user changes. To start this challenge, we need to launch the developer edition org. For that, click on this launch button. Then you will be redirected to this setup page. So let's move to the instructions. So here are the instructions that we need to complete. And what we need to do is we need to make some changes in this opportunity updater flow. So move to the setup page and in this quick find search for flows. So click on these flows and from these flows search for opportunity updater. So here it is, just click on that. So this is the opportunity updater flow, and after this update opportunity screen, click on this plus icon. And here search for assignment. So click on this assignment and then type the label name as assign index values. So after that, in this variable, search variable as, click on this current item from loop and now search for name. So here it is, click on that. And after that, leave the operator value as equals, and for this value, search for oop underscore name. So select this oop underscore name and then again click on this add assignment button and now search the variable as current item from loop and then here select it as account ID as equals and then search for the value as oop underscore account. So here it is, click on this oop underscore account. And from here, click on this record ID. And after that, again, click on this add assignment. And here, click on this search variable. Again, select this current item from loop. And now, select it as close date. So here, click on this close date. And leave the operator value as equals as is. And then, select the value as oop underscore close date. So here it is, oop underscore close underscore date. And after that, again click on this add assignment and in this search variables again search for current item from loop and at this time select it as description. So just search for description. So here it is. After that, leave the operator value as equals as is and then search the value as oop underscore description. So select it. So after selecting all of these values and all of these four assignments, just click on this cross icon at the top. And after that, again click on this plus icon below this assignment and again search for assignment. So at this time, enter the label as assign collection records. So for this variable, so click on this plus new resource and here for this resource type, select it as variable and then type the API name as collection opportunity. So don't give spaces. And after that, select the data type as record. And here select the checkbox for allow multiple values and now search the object as opportunity. Then click on this done button. So after that, for this operator select it as add and for this value select it as current item and then remove this dot symbol at the end. Just click on this cross icon at the top. So before this end, click on this plus button and here search for update records. So type the label as update opportunities. And then for this record collection, select it as collection opportunity. So here it is. So after selecting, just click on this cross icon And after updating these elements, just click on the Save as New Version and then click on the Save button. And also click on this Activate button. So like this, we completed the second challenge. Move to the instructions, scroll down to the last, and then click on this Check Challenge button. So yeah, we completed this whole flow collections and loop super batch unit without any errors. And please do check out our channel Education Matters for next challenge answers and also super batch answers. And also please share our channel to your friends. It will help them too. That's it. Thank you.